Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing top 8 skills that you need in order to become successful data analyst. These are the skills that they'll be asking during the interview, as well as once you become a data analyst, if you have these 8 skills, you can really become successful in your career. Skill number 1 is Excel. Believe it or not, Microsoft Excel is still widely used in the industry for doing data analysis, and it is perfect for the small data sets. And if you have knowledge of Excel formulas, the VBA formulas, charting, pivot table, different transpose techniques, etc., you will have an edge compared to your peers. Skill number 2 is SQL. It is called Structured Query Language. Now, SQL you can do in MySQL, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle. There are different databases on which you can run Structured Query Language to fetch the data, to do different operations with that data. And as a data analyst, you are often involved in a data exploration, data collection, and all those operations. So having SQL skills will be extremely useful. Skill number 3 is you should know at least one visualization tool such as Power BI or Tableau. These are the two most popular ones, but there are many out there in the industry. And if you have learned at least one tool, you can easily learn some other tools. So if you are asking me for my choice, I would go for either Power BI or Tableau. But once you have learned one tool, you can learn other tools easily. These tools allow you to connect with the data sources, and you can pull that data into this visualization tools, and you can build a lot of useful dashboards. I have done one Sales Insight project using a Power BI, and if you look at that project series, you will figure out how useful that tool is in terms of building interactive dashboards. So once you build the dashboard, it will look more like an application. You can also export that dashboard as a mobile app. So when someone is looking at the mobile app, they can interact and they can use various UI controls to fetch the data, to fetch different reports and different visualizations dashboards. So visualization tool nowadays is extremely important. Number 4 is communication and presentation skills. When you are becoming a data analyst, you are often talking with your business manager, your engineering groups, and different stakeholders. And your job is to communicate the requirements, or let's say gather the requirements in an effective way and offer creative solutions. You also need presentation skills, because data, as a data analyst, you are telling your data story. When you are building a dashboard, let's say for Sales Insights, you are building a story around sales are declining in, let's say, a particular region, or they're increasing in other region, and what is the reason behind this decline or behind the growth. So telling that data story is important, and presentation skills is something that you need to master. I'm gonna link some video for how to master the presentation skills. It's called Death by Presentation. So if you are preparing any presentation, make sure you watch that video. And the idea is you should not get your audience too much bored with your presentation, and you should have an effective and engaging presentation. So that's very important. Skill number 5 is domain knowledge. Often if you're looking at a data analyst job position, they will say financial data analyst or retail data analyst. What it means is if you have a degree in finance, or let's say if you have done masters or specialization in retail, that domain knowledge is going to be extremely useful. Many times people ask me that I have to have a computer science degree in order to become data analyst. No, you do not need computer science degree. In fact, if you have specialization, let's say if you've done Bachelor of Commerce and or if you have a degree in finance, or let's say in retail or some industry, then that domain knowledge will be extremely useful, because as a data analyst, you are solving problems in particular domain, and having that knowledge helps you do data analysis in an effective way. The next skill, which is not very much required, there are many companies which do not ask for this skill, is programming. So nowadays Python and R are two very popular programming languages. I personally prefer Python. If you're just starting out, just go with Python. Having programming knowledge will give you an edge over the competition. So if I'm hiring a data analyst, I have two resumes, exact same skills, but let's say if one of the resumes have Python, I would just go with that person or any other programming knowledge, because programming knowledge is not a must for a data analyst, but it is a plus. So if you have that, it will definitely help you. I have a nice tutorial playlist on Python. Even a fifth grade student can learn from this tutorial playlist. So I have linked again that tutorial playlist in the video description below. You can check it out. You need to watch just first 15 or 16 videos. And Python programming is so easy and it's so convenient to learn that anyone can learn it. So if you have time, especially during lockdown, please learn Python, because it will be very, very helpful. But as I said before, some of the companies do not ask for it. So even if you don't have programming knowledge as a data analyst, you might end up doing just okay. The next skill is mathematics and statistics. So when you're doing data analysis, you are, let's say, looking at your data distribution. You need to know what is normal distribution, standard deviation, two standard deviation, how to remove outliers. So you need to have basic math and statistics knowledge. You should know basics about inferential statistics and descriptive statistics. You don't need to be super genius in math and statistics, okay? So just have basic knowledge, and as you work on solving real life problems, you should try to enhance your knowledge in mathematics and statistics. The last skill is problem solving. Now, this is a common sense approach. It's a general skill where you need to be street smart and you need to be offering different solution for a given problem. So there is no like one silver bullet that I can tell you, or no one magic trick that I can tell you to improve your problem solving skill, but it's a general smartness that you need to have. So I hope you like this video. All these 8 skills are super important if you want to get a data analyst job, or if you want to become successful in your data analyst career. I have another video where I have shown how you can learn data analyst skills for free, where I have linked all the online resources, and all of these resources are for free. So if you have enough motivation, one computer and internet, you can learn all these skills for free sitting at your home in this lockdown. So if you are thinking of changing your career to data analyst, it's definitely a good idea. There are so many jobs being open for data analyst, and I see many people transitioning from, let's say, mechanical engineering or BCom or different backgrounds to a data analyst career. If that is something that excites you, you should definitely consider this as an option. I have a couple of videos on my channel where a couple of mechanical engineers and BCom graduates made a transition and they became a successful data analyst. Right now they're working for some big companies. So go watch those videos as well if you want to get some tips. I hope you like this. Thank you very much. Bye.